Hey everybody, Randal Schwartz back again with another tip, trick, or technique about the world of Dart and Flutter. Let's go. So here's the problem we're trying to look at today. So suppose I have some data and I want to know whether that data is of a particular type. This is a common thing that happens when you're getting data back from Firebase or your decoding JSON, because both of those produce this pile of lists and maps of typically type dynamic, so you can't get anything out of that. So what I've got here is the number 42 being placed into a dynamic variable. I'm deliberately declaring it dynamic so that it doesn't use any compile time hints to do the rest of this code, because that would give away the whole solution immediately. So, we know that int data is some variable of unknown type, and now we want to see, is this perhaps an int, so that I can do int-related operations on it. Now, a common thing that people do, although as we're about to show, it's incorrect, is to go ahead and call runtimeType on that, and then start comparing that in various ways to int. I'm going to save that for a moment, although I'm going to go ahead and run this code right now. And we're going to see that the runtime type is, in fact, int, just like we would expect. Okay, now, so the traditional best way of trying to compute whether it's an int or not is to use is. So we're going to say, is int data, is it an int? Yes, it is. We do get that. Okay, and how about doing it this way, using the new Dart 3 patterns? So we've got int data as part of a switch. We then do a pattern match on int paren paren, which is in fact, say, is this an instance of type int or any of its subclasses? There aren't any subclasses to int, so that's pretty safe. And that's one way to write that pattern. And of course, we'll again see that int via switch case is correct. We also have an if case that we can use. And again, there's a pattern over on the right-hand side. And of course, via the if case, it is in fact detected properly. So those are all three pretty standard ways of doing this and the preferred ways of doing this. What I see people doing occasionally is something like this. If they type runtime type is int. Now this does work because in fact, the values for the type of int and the value that comes back are compatible inside well enough that it can go ahead and say those are equal. And so yes, we get int via runtime type. Similarly, we can pass the runtime type down into a case, and that of course again is the same exact match as doing this double equal here, and so that also works. And you can even use it with the if case. Okay, so far it looks like, Randall, what are you harping about in terms of runtime type not being useful? Well, this may be the kind of code you wrote so far, and everything works fine, and so then you come along, and it's time to go test out map. So here I have a map. Once again, I'm declaring it dynamic so that we don't have any compile time indication of what this data is. We're relying entirely on what the system has recorded about the runtime type of this value here. Yeah, I'm just going to go ahead and run this. So we'll go back here, comment out the first part. We don't need to see it anymore. We're going to open up the second part, and we're going to run this. And what we're going to see is that, scroll back to where we were. Right, what we're going to see is that the runtime type here is, in fact, this really interesting thing, which isn't in any of the documentation, although it's in the source code system, of course, of a const map of string. Okay, I don't even know what that is. Okay, that doesn't show up in any of the documentation, but I bet it's a kind of a map. So I can kind of guess that. But it's definitely not the letters MAP. But we can still go ahead and say, is this map data a map or one of its subclasses? And in fact, yes, it is a map. So this is a proper way to detect that this is a map or something it acts at least map-like. And again, we can do the same pattern match that we did before. Map data. Again, we're going to do a map pattern. So that's the proper way to write that. Don't write it without the parens there, because that means, is it literally the type called map? Which is, it's not. It's the data that is an instance of the map class. And that also works. The switch case works, right? And even the if case works. If map data case map, boom, we get the right thing. And here's where people go off the rails. They say, oh, I need to tell the runtime type, and I hope it's map. Okay, I expected a map for this data. Well, guess what? That doesn't work. It's not a map according to that. And that's because this value is not equal anymore to this value. As we saw earlier, this is actually const map string string, which is not double equals, apparently, to map by itself. So that's not going to work at all. And we can keep going on with this, but I think you're going to see the pattern here. The moment I've used runtime type, map no longer applies, even though it is a map, but it's a subclass of map. That's an internal-only implementation detail. So I hope this demonstrated that, yes, you can detect you can detect maps, provided you use one of the straightforward strategies, is map or a map pattern matching, and so on. But don't use runtime type to try to pick that out. Hope you enjoyed this presentation. If so, like and subscribe. And also you can buy me a coffee or join my Patreon. Both of the links are in the show notes. Thanks a lot.